Hello, welcome to Skye's Sweaty Record Review, the only new music review show hosted by a French professor immediately after getting out of the YMCA and currently being stalked by a dog. This is episode 103, and I'm going to be reviewing an album by the band called Kompromat. Now, I was drawn to the album. The cover's pretty cool. You can get a sense of it there. It's like these people in white shirts and black ties and weird masks over their faces. And then the title is in German. It's, let me find it here, Traum und Existenz, which I assume means trauma and existence. Correct me, I have some German sweatpants out there who watch my show. Correct me if I'm wrong. And so I got excited. I'm like, that sounds interesting. And I looked up, and like half the songs were in French. So I thought, okay. And so I was on Tidal, and I clicked on the button that says more about this artist. And the number one song of theirs on Tidal is called Trump Dump. I thought, is this like some kind of anti-Trump band? Are they called Kompromat because of the Russian term meaning compromise, which is what the Russians have on Trump? I thought, this is not very promising. But I listened to the first song and I thought, this is really good. So I'll just assume that whatever Trump Dump was Juvenalia. I ended up listening to Trump Dump. It's a totally different band. Kompromat, there's like a couple bands named that, so don't confuse them. The song Trump Dump is not particularly good, but the album Traum und Existenz is astounding. It turns out it's by Vitalik, who's like this French EDM guy, and what's her name? Rebecca Warrior, who's a German singer? I don't know, I'd never even heard of her. So they got together and made this sort of pan-European electronic dance music. I found that out by searching them on Facebook. I had to like figure out like, what is the mystery? Is this the Trump Dump band or is this something else? And so I found that out and then I read the description of their own music. I don't usually like to do this, but their description of their own music is so good, it's going to do a better job than I can. And I'm pretty arrogant and I think I can describe things pretty well, but they did it perfectly. This is what they said about their own music. It's like you are lifting your hands in the air while dancing and crying. So there it is. You know, you're dancing. That's the emotion they're trying to go for. And that's the emotion that they hit. And listen, if you like electronic music, if you're not scared by foreign languages, and that sounds good to you, dancing while crying, just stop watching this and go listen to the album and then come back and let me know what you think of it. It's really quite interesting. The end of the album is way better than the beginning, which isn't usually the case. Usually artists front load their album. The first track is called Possession, although I suppose it's probably Possession. I don't know. There's no English at all on this entire album. It's all either in German or in French, and I'll get into that soon. It's cool because it has like this haunting keyboard, you know, really feels like a keyboard in a cathedral that's been abandoned for 100 years. And then this children's chorus comes in. So you have this German woman in this kind of sultry, smoky, sexy voice, talk singing, and then a children's chorus singing in French. And what are they singing? Well, I didn't understand the German, I didn't understand the French. You know, we are nobody, we understand nothing, we know nothing, we hear nothing. With this nice kind of delicate melody. And that sets you up quite nicely for how the whole album is going to sound. The next track is the title track, nice kind of German vocals. A lot of this album seems to be playing with the interplay between French and German. I mean, this is obviously a bicultural album, but the music is often so airy and just like delicate and simplistic at times, you know, like just like, you know, maybe one button automated arpeggiator. One song is even just one note. That's very soft and in some ways not challenging. And then the German language comes in and kind of punches you in the face the way the German language often does. And then sometimes there's actually French in there as well, such as on the song De Mon Âme à Ton Âme, From My Soul to Yours. And that's the best example of where this language difference really creates interesting back and forth. I'll play a little bit of that song right now, mainly because I understood some of the lyrics here. One second. So there's the nice French.
And then...
Diese Nächte sind ein paar Augenblicke der Ewigkeit.
French. He just falls asleep. It's so delicate, this nice French. As long as there's no German, we should be all set. Okay, obviously I'm playing around a little bit here. I can hear my kids just in hell whenever I make these kinds of jokes. But you kind of hear that, right? Like this really interesting interplay. And I'm not trying to make it too simple. Some of the singing in German is delicate and gentle. And obviously you can't just divide it that easily. But this album does a really good job of doing that. I think it's that idea of dancing and crying, the kind of happy and unhappy at the same time, the sort of pains of existence. Like I said, the album really hits its stride with the last four tracks. So, Le Goût des Cendres, The Taste of Ashes, is this amazing song where, like, the rhythm just kind of keeps building and then gets lost. Like, other elements come on, so like, do, 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 and then something else will come on after and be like, do, 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 on top of the do, do, do. Listen to it. I'm not doing the best job. But it is really nice because it creates this really odd polyrhythms and like you can't quite dance to it, but you sort of want to. And then the French sings, and then I think she comes in with German versions of the lyrics afterwards. You know, I'm gonna play a little bit of that to you as well. I wasn't going to, but here's a little bit of Le Goût des Cendres. You can hear the offbeat rhythms. You hear in the background? You know, you got that sort of like broken robot feel. About to go into sprockets here. So it starts off nice and sparse like this. And then it picks up when it goes into German. It hits a little bit more of a poppy, upbeat part. Right here. Not here. Right really soon. Right here. Right here. Alright, they're just messing with me now. I guess they're never gonna go into the cool German part that gets a little bit upbeat. It's just never gonna happen, so I just might as well give up. Ah, here we go. You hear that? A transition? It keeps some of that like crazy polyrhythm from the beginning, but brings up the upbeat song, the kind of upbeat rhythms. Ah, it's great. It's another one of these albums I really don't think I'm gonna get that much out of it the first listen. I mean, I got a lot out of it, but I can't wait to listen to it more because it just gets deeper and deeper. Plus, tonight, I'm going to a party with a couple Germans who are never impressed with my knowledge of German culture. So I'll bring this up to them and they'll be like, yeah, there are plenty of musicians from Germany. This does not surprise me. So, I don't know. But I'll try to get them to tell me what some of these lyrics mean. The next song, Auf immer und ewig, is another great track. This one is strictly in German. I'll play just a small clip from that. And this is more of their real dancing style. So you can hear, it's just super upbeat the whole way through. You know, a lot of beats per minute. Ooh, ghosts. And then it ends with a song called Das Konterfei. I assume it means the counterfeit. Now, mind you, the first time I listened to this album, like, I was sort of thinking, is this all going to be just, like, bad criticisms of Trump in German? Like, my German wasn't good enough to really be able to pick it up. But I don't think that's what this is all about. So I'm looking forward to finding out what the lyrics really are. I assume this means the counterfeit. And this is really cool because it's a song, and then the exact same song with a remix. But the way they did it was, they did it the first time where it's the song with just electronic instruments, right? So, you hear it here. One second. It's kind of a slow song. Mostly vocal, actually. Like, line after line of the same vocalist coming in, singing different parts. But you hear in the background, it's just keyboards. I'll shut up. Schlange, schon weiß, ich bin, ich bin. And then the last track is the same song, except with strings and a full orchestra instead of electronic instruments. By the time I was done, I was extremely happy about this album. It's cool because, I mean, maybe you won't want to listen to it because you won't understand any of the words. I only understood like 20% of the words because most of it's in German. But there's something so unbelievably European about this album. You know, there's not a single word of English. And most electronic artists just sing in English because they want the market, you know? The best do. Daft Punk and Mode Selector and Justice. You know, they all have to give in to English. But there's something about this that feels maybe defiantly European. I don't know if I want to say that. I just did say it, so I guess I did want to say it. But it has that sort of intellectual, unapologetic air that one can really enjoy when studying European culture. It's not afraid to be smart. It's not afraid of alienating you. It's extremely well made. It's not trying to please you. It's not looking for a happy ending. It's not looking to lift you up. It's trying to create a specific emotion. Trauma and existence. Dancing and crying. It's excellent. It's really, really good. And I'm very happy that I found it. And I'm very happy that it was not 47 minutes of you staying in a Trump dump, which now, I know you guys, I know my audience, you're now going to look for the Trump dump song. It's not worth it. Oh, first time, by the way, ever, I'm using my my daughter's Minion headphones. So a lot of people don't know, Minions are actually French. Created by some Frenchmen there. All right, well, this week's gonna be a little funny. I'm gonna be going to a convention in Chicago during the week. So I don't know if I'm gonna get to my 3 episodes this week. I might do something special, I might not. But in the event that I don't, I'll catch you next week, because new music is the fountain of mental youth. And until next time, there's the camera. But where's the dog? Toby? You here? I guess he lost interest. He didn't stay all the way through. It's terrible for my click-through rates.